Most of the first-class passengers joining Titanic at Cherbourg are wealthy Americans and Britons, accustomed to the luxury they are about to experience. Millionaire John Jacob Astor IV and his young wife Madeline are returning from their honeymoon, braced for scandal in New York. Outspoken philanthropist Margaret Molly Brown, fashion designer Lucille Lady Duff Gordon and her titled husband Sir Cosmo, President Taft's military advisor Major Archibald Butt, mining tycoon Benjamin Guggenheim and his mistress, Madame Aubert.
quite a fine artist. He's kind enough to show me some of his work today.
Those men differ somewhat in our definition of fine art. Not to impugn your own, sir.
I hear they're quite good on this ship.
The best I've seen, ma'am. Hardly any rats. After that, I'm on God's good humor.
And how is it you have means to travel?
I work my way from place to place. You know, tramp steamers and such. But I won my ticket on Titanic here, a lucky hand at poker. Very lucky.
Your life is a game of luck.
A real man makes his own luck.
And you find that sort of hopeless existence appealing?
Yes, ma'am, I do. Got everything I need right.
At noon on Thursday the 11th, Titanic drops anchor at Cove Harbor, the deep water port of Queenstown, Ireland. Two tenders, the Ireland and the America, bring aboard port officials, journalists, 120 passengers, their luggage, and nearly 1,500 mail bags. On Saturday evening, April 13th, Titanic receives an ice warning, her second via Morse lamp from the crippled steamer Rappahannock. Sailing eastward from Halifax to London, the Furness-Withy Line's ship has damaged her rudder and bow in heavy ice not too far to the west. Titanic flashes a brief acknowledgement and continues on course. Sunday aboard Titanic, church services are held in every class. Captain Smith leads the prayers in the first class dining room. A perfect April Sunday at sea has come to a close. Titanic is making good time, steaming westward at 22 and a half knots. Her engines pound and howl deep within her hull. At about 26 miles per hour, she is running close to her top speed. Her propellers drive through the near-freezing water at a reckless pace. Titanic has almost no margin for quick maneuvers. All aboard Titanic feel safe within the grand machinery of Gilded Age progress.
Ladies, time being, I shall require only women and children. Please, gentlemen, stay where you are.
This way, madam, please.
Really, I'd rather not.
Thank you, sir. Madam, please stop.
Thank you. I'm gonna need you now. The sun will be above.
I've reached the panic man. Steady.
You, sir. Sir, that's your unsinkable ship.